So just how many chisels do you actually need to woodwork? Well, far less than what you see here for starters. Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Sponsored by
MicroJig, maker of the Gripper. Work safer, work smarter.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. So on today's episode, I am going to attempt to answer a question that has been around for years. I see this one quite frequently in the social medias, and I get asked this periodically also. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. And that question is, what chisels should I have? What should I own? Should I get an entire set? Should I get a couple of sets, depending on what it is? Like, have a bench set that's just gets beat around quite a bit? Should I have a nice set for when I really want to do some delicate work? What would you recommend? And my answer is, obviously, I have quite a few chisels. In fact, this is the majority of them. I just got a couple of new ones that came in thanks to a great friend of the show who happened to have sent me this nice set over here. He also discovered the other two that he hadn't sent and were sending in my direction. But this is a little misconceiving when it comes down to it. This is a lot misconceiving, actually, because I don't use all of these chisels, and that's actually my answer. You do not need a monster set of chisels, as pretty much I have here, and I've got a few other ones over there. Really, when it comes down to it, quite honestly, all you need is just maybe a couple of chisels. In fact, I am going to go so far as to say for brand new woodworkers, really you only need three bench chisels to really get you started. In fact, actually you don't even need those three right away. You can add one as they go, which may actually open up the opportunity to purchase some really, really nice versions of them. So which ones am I talking about? Well, I'm going to go ahead and grab my blue marbles because these ones have been with me forever. Unfortunately, I know, I think they're going by a different name as of right now. Who knows? Maybe depending on when you see this, it might be an entirely different name. But when it comes down to it, the three that I would recommend is, one of them is a quarter inch chisel. And then I'll give you a choice here. This is where you really get to choose. Either a 3/8 or a half inch version. Either one work really, really well. And in fact, I really can't decide which one I use more. I think I actually use, am I kidding? I use the half inch more. So it's a quarter inch, that's a half inch. And then my third chisel that I would highly recommend is, I would recommend getting a 1-inch chisel. To be completely open and honest about it, I guarantee you that these are the three chisels that I use probably easily 90% of the time that I actually do any work with my chisels. And as you can notice, these are two different manufacturers. Again, these are those blue chip marples from years and years ago, and this is actually a Lee Valley version. In fact, I think this one is still available. They might even have it in a shorter length, which is often called a butt chisel, if I remember correctly, because they kind of fit in the butt of your hand. At least that's one of the stories I've heard. It's always funny how names of tools kind of get passed around as to what they actually mean. But quite honestly, again, those are the three main chisels that I would recommend. From that point forward, if as you start to increase your woodworking, maybe you'll discover that there are some other versions of chisels that you want to purchase. And I bet at some point, one of them for certain that you will probably really want to consider, especially if you really start getting more and more into doing a lot of handwork, is a mortising chisel. And this is a Lee Nielsen quarter inch mortising chisel. And this is another set of chisels that I know a lot of people will get like really overthinking and almost obsessed with the fact that they feel like they have to have a full set. But again, this is one of those situations where I only have the quarter inch chisel. And quite honestly, the majority of the work that I have ever done when it came to mortising by hand was with a quarter inch. Maybe I might have picked up a 3/8 instead, but for certain, I have a feeling that this quarter inch chisel, this mortising chisel, will be probably the main one that I will use all of the time. There are some fun little chisels that eventually maybe you could add to your collection, but you may discover that you don't use them nearly as often as you think you would. And for example, that would happen to be this fishtail chisel that, again, I picked up from the folks over at Lee Nielsen. It's a really fun idea, the way that it kind of splays out here, the way it kind of it angles out. It really helps to get into tight corners, including ones that I made using this mortising chisel. It allows me to kind of get in there and really clean up the corners. A lot of people especially like to use this fishtail chisel, and I've used it once or twice on hand-cut dovetails, because again, you can kind of get in there and clean those out, and that's really, really helpful. If you do find that you have a lot of chisels because you are one of those people, again, that just kind of collects them as you go because you felt like you had to, there are different things that you can do with these chisels. There's different ways you can set them up. You could easily have, again, maybe the two or three chisels that you bang around quite a bit, your hardcore bench chisels. If that's the case, then perhaps you want to put a little bit of a, let me grab this for example, a little bit of a heavier bevel angle on it so that it will definitely hold up to more of that hitting and what's what I'm looking for here, resistance from the wood. Really, you can bang these around quite considerably. My suggestion is putting a little bit steeper bevel angle on there. In fact, this one, I know I wrote it on here someplace. Yep, I have a 35 degree micro bevel on here. And that's one thing I found is that when my chisels, carefully put that cover on there, you might have freaked out a little bit, looked like I was gonna cut myself. Probably came pretty close. But really when it comes down to it, that micro bevel, the bevel that you end up putting on your chisels, if you're finding that it's starting to dull really quickly, and some manufacturers of chisels, you might actually notice this, I'm not gonna go ahead and name them, try putting a steeper bevel angle on it, and you may actually find that bevel holds its sharpness just a little bit longer. So in that case, mine is at 35. It's not saying that the Lee Valley version, that's not a PMV11 steel. I think that one's a 01 or an A2. But it, by putting that higher bevel angle on there, it has really helped to increase the length of that cutting angle. Another thing that you could potentially do, and I'm just trying to think of, let me just grab one of these ones over here, because these ones definitely will work great as a bench chisel, but one thing I've really been considering doing with this is putting a shallower bevel on this, maybe like 20, 25, somewhere around there, and using this particular version as a paring chisel. And what that does is, by having that lower bevel angle on there, you can really take this material and kind of clean up a surface. Maybe you want to clean up a shoulder, maybe you want to clean up a tenon. Paring is really great for that because you're not putting a lot of exertion on the cutting edge itself. You're taking very light, shallow passes, and having that lower bevel angle allows you to make really, really light passes that just take off delicate shavings. And so that might be something, again, if you've somehow amassed a collection of chisels like I have, that could be something you could potentially do with them. Have one set for really just beating around, putting that higher bevel angle on, and then another set maybe for more delicate work sets, such as paring and putting a very shallow bevel on it. Or again, maybe if you're just getting started, take my advice and just get that two or maybe or three chisels that you will use all the time. Like I said, for certain, these are the three that I go to constantly. There's probably a lot more that we could talk about with chisels, but I think this is a good place to stop right now before we get too deep into it. Like I said, it can be an addiction where you want to start buying one of everything. I know we feel that way about our router bits, but with the chisels, definitely do yourself a favor, save a few bucks, maybe buy a much higher quality chisel. I'm not going to give you name brands or anything like that because I really don't want to go in that direction. These ones have worked great for me for years. But anyways, that's just one thing to consider when it comes to buying your chisels. Now, if you have comments, questions, suggestions, I'd love to hear from all of you. You know how to get a hold of me. You can email me at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com. Of course, you can stop by the website at mattsbasementworkshop.com and leave a comment over there. Of course, if you're watching this at YouTube, you can leave a comment on our YouTube channel. I love hearing from all of you. So until the next time, straight grains and sharp blades. And I don't know which tool we're going to talk about next, but I'm sure we've got something on here that we can definitely dive into. So until then, take care, everybody.
Thanks for watching. For more information on topics discussed in this episode, visit mattsbasementworkshop.com.